We're going to talk about triperfect numbers. Triperfect numbers, we've heard of perfect numbers, haven't we? We've done that on Numberphile before. It was one of our first ones, wasn't it? I think we need to do a quick recap of what a perfect number is, because that's going to be relevant to what a triperfect number is. So a perfect number is a number like six. Six is a perfect number. And that's because factors of six are 1, 2, 3, and 6 itself. In fact, what we're going to do, we're going to ignore the number itself. If we add up the other factors, so we'll have 1 plus 2 plus 3, we're going to end up with the original number. We're going to have 6. The next perfect number is 28, and it works the same way. If you look at the factors of 28 and add them up, you'll get the original number. The next one is going to be 496. That's a perfect number. The next one after that is 8,128, and they keep going, right? So they're quite rare. We think there's infinitely many of them, but we've found 50 so far. The largest one we found is the most recent, which is a perfect number that is 46 million digits long. So we do think there's infinitely many of them, although we haven't proven that to be true. And all the perfect numbers we found are even. We haven't found an odd perfect number yet, so that's something that hasn't been proven yet. But this definition I gave you was kind of weird because I ignored the number itself. So I said add up all the factors except the number itself. You could just add all the factors, including the number itself. That's perfectly fine. And then you could say a perfect number is you add up all the factors and you get double the original number. That's absolutely fine. What happens if we add up all the factors and get triple the number? That is a triperfect number. Well, the smallest triperfect number is 120. If we look at the factors of 120, you have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 8, 10, 12, 15, 20 is a factor, 24, 30, 40, 60, and we'll include 120 itself. So those are the factors of 120, and if you add them up, you will get 360. You will get 3 times the original number. So that is the first triperfect number. Let me write out the next few. Let's start a list here with 120, and the next one is 672. The next triperfect number after that is 523,776. The next one after that is 459,818,240. The next one after that is 1,476,304,896. And the next one after that, and I might put this one in, I'll put it here, 51,001,180,160. So I've got 6 there written out, and that's all of them. That's all we know, and we also think that's a complete list. We think there's finitely many of them. We think there's 6 of them only. That is a complete list. There are 6 triperfect numbers. Now that's not proven, but we really do believe that this is a complete list. A couple of reasons for this. We have searched for them. And we've searched quite a long way. We've searched huge numbers, like numbers that are 350 digits long, like really big numbers, but they just stop. So we have a triperfect number in the hundreds. We have triperfect numbers in the thousands. We have them in the millions. We have them in the billions, and then they just stop. And it would be really weird if there was some sort of massive triperfect number so that there's this massive, massive gap. And then another triperfect number suddenly appears. That would be really weird if that's true. Now, we don't know that this is a complete list, but it would be really weird if it wasn't a complete list. And there is other reasons why we think this is a complete list, because it's also related to perfect numbers. In fact, it's related to odd perfect numbers. If you remember, I said we haven't found any odd perfect numbers yet. And there is a relation between odd perfect numbers and triperfect numbers. If you had a number, let's just call it n, and if that is odd perfect, then 2n is triperfect. So that means that if we do find an odd perfect number one day, and it's going to be massive if we ever find it. If we find it one day, then automatically we're going to find a new triperfect number. So either we're going to find this odd perfect number, and this list is not complete after all, or this list is complete, which means there aren't any odd perfect numbers, which we also believe, not proven, but we strongly believe that's true.
James, are there quad perfect numbers?
I'm glad you asked, because yes, absolutely. So there are four perfect numbers, five perfect numbers. Shall I show you them? We can look at them. I've got them, yeah.
That wasn't set up. That was a real question.
The smallest four perfect number that we know is 30,240. So if you look at the factors of that number and add them up, you'll get four times the original number. There are 36 known four perfect numbers. And then the list just stops again. And then we can't find any more. So we think, again, we've got a finite list here. And we think we have all the four perfect numbers. You can take it a step further, of course. Look at five perfect numbers. The smallest five perfect number is 14,182,439,040. There's 65 of those that we know of, that we found. And again, it's the same thing. It looks like it's a finite list because we found 65 of them and then it just stops and we can't find any more. So we think that's a finite list as well. Same is true for six perfect numbers and seven perfect numbers. We think we found a complete list, then they just stop.
If you love numbers, and I think maybe you do because you're here watching Numberphile, then you really should check out Brilliant, a site full of quizzes, puzzles, courses, all dedicated to mathematics and science. Among them is this course here on number theory. It's one of my favourites. And you can see here a few problems specifically about perfect numbers. Brilliant is a treasure trove of interactive content that's going to make you really love learning. It's good fun and makes you a bit smarter along the way. Now there's a whole bunch of stuff on the site for free, but you can also get 20% off Brilliant's premium membership, which gives you even more stuff, by going to brilliant.org/numberphile. That also tells Brilliant you came from here, so that's good for Numberphile too. Our thanks to them for supporting this episode, and I'll include in the description some links to some excellent stuff on Brilliant you might want to have a look at.